And it's Ken Kreitzer for Sons of American Legion Radio, rallypoint.com, and today the Association of the U.S. Army, a chance to talk with Army Athletic Director Boo Corr again. And Boo, great to see you. Never tire of these media days. What is the thought about preparing for the Army-Navy game? You're working at it all year, the build-up, television, tickets. But what does it mean for you? What's it been like for you and your experience?
You know, it's kind of the pinnacle of the season, right? We've been able to play one Power 5 school in September, which has been great for us. And then, you know, early November, you've got Air Force. And then, you know, next week is the Army-Navy week. And we're the one game in town for college football. And I think it's kind of the place that we want to be. And I think it's the place where a lot of the eyes of America are.
Absolutely. And getting to know the seniors on your team, any of them we've known since they were freshmen, talking just now with Bryce Holland and Darnell Woolfolk has had such a great year, Andy Davidson, guys on defense, Ken Brinson, a Campbell Trophy Award finalist. What has it been watching this group of seniors develop and demonstrate the leadership that they have?
I think you can almost across the board on all of our teams, when we're successful, we've got a great firstie class. And I think that leadership that they provide, their ability to look down and grab people up that are in the classes below them, really sets the tone. And I think these guys have been through an awful lot in their time at West Point, have been part of the turn of the football program, have been Monk's guys from the start. And I think that's really important that they bought in and went all in early to get us to where we are today.
And if we just tell us a little bit about the overall year in athletics at West Point. You've got a lot of teams playing, both men's and women's. We're starting the men's and women's basketball seasons, hockey. We were talking with Coach Riley last week. Just tell us about all the different sports that you have competing at West Point.
Well, the good thing is we come out of the fall, both soccer teams made the Patriot League tournament. Volleyball was this close to making it. Sprint football had a great year. Obviously, football has done well. Men's cross country won the Patriot League championship. Women had a good year. And now we're, as you just said, headed into basketball season and wrestling and everything else is going on. You know, it's always a dynamic time. This time of year when the fall sports are ending and the winter sports are starting, and hockey's gotten off to a really good start. So, you know, never a dull moment at West Point.
And, you know, we read a lot of articles. We know that facilities are so important to a college athletic program. You've added a new lacrosse building in recent years, another football field, a building in the works for sprint football. Why are facilities so important? What are some of the other things you have on the drawing board?
I just think it's, as an academy, I think we kind of owe it back. And we had some facilities that were a little bit older and some adjustments we needed to make in there with the Foley Enters Nathy lacrosse building and being able to move both women and men's lacrosse in there. The Anderson Athletic Center is going to go in down below the plane. That'll take care of volleyball, softball, sprint football, have a new weight room down there, a new nutrition center. And then, of course, the East Stands project that we're working on right now, which we call the Mikey Stadium Preservation Project, which we're in the process right now raising money for, working with architects. And, you know, hopefully here in the next couple of years we'll break ground on that, and that'll move the entire athletic department up to above the plane, up where Mikey Stadium is, and really change our footprint.
I just got to ask you, you know, it's very unique that you went out to Oklahoma, great day, great performance by the team, 87,000 people. But your arrangement is that they're coming back to West Point. Is that still on schedule? How does that look?
No, that's still I talked to Joe Castiglione yesterday, the AD at Oklahoma, and they're thrilled beyond belief to be coming to Mikey Stadium. And pending construction, if we're not under construction at that point, we will definitely play the game at Mikey Stadium.
Very good. And I remember the day Stanford came in a few years ago. What a wonderful the buzz that day of the stadium, absolutely full, seeing a Pac-10 team come in. What a wonderful occasion that was for Mikey Stadium. What do you enjoy the most about being athletic director? Your family's had a long history in college athletics. And what do you enjoy most about being the athletic director at West Point?
Beyond talking to you? No, I think it's the interaction that you have with the cadets. And while I don't get a ton of that, because I think my job is not necessarily to be with them, but be providing everything they need to have a good experience. Looking backwards and getting notes from cadets that have gone through, you know, when they're out in the Army, when they're changing units and understanding, hey, being an athlete means an awful lot to me. It's helped me in my career. I think those notes that you get periodically is what really makes the whole thing special.
Absolutely. Great to talk with Boo Corrigan, the athletic director of the United States Military Academy. Best wishes from everybody at the American Legion, rallypoint.com, and our friends at the Association of the U.S. Army. Good to see you.
All right, brother. Good to be with you. Thanks.
Pleasure. Ken Kreitzer at Army Navy Media Day.